guys, it's Missy. Welcome back. Today's tutorial is this half up hairstyle. I'm not quite sure what to call it yet, but I hope you enjoyed the video. I recently launched an online store and the little accessories I'm using in today's video can be found there. I'll leave a link down below in the description box in case you want to check it out. There's a lot of really cute fun things. And if you're new to my channel, as always, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you never miss a future video. And let's get started. With my hair parted on the right side, I'm going to start by picking up a small section of hair next to the part to begin the first waterfall twist. It's going to be a little bit further back because the next twists are going to be in front of this section. So I'm just going to divide this piece in half and start by crossing the left strand over the right strand. And then I'm going to pick up a new piece of hair from behind this section where it started and cross it over the right strand and under the left strand before dropping it down. And then I'm just going to clip this hanging piece out of the way so it stays in place while I continue the braid. And now I'm going to cross the left strand over the right strand again, pick up a new section of hair and cross it over the right strand and under the left strand before dropping it down again. And then I'm just going to clip this out of the way, and this is a new waterfall piece with the first one. So now I'm going to repeat those steps again. So I'm crossing the left strand over the right strand. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair and cross it over the right strand and under the left strand before dropping it down again. And then I'm just going to clip away this new waterfall piece with the first one. So once more, I'm crossing the left strand over the right strand. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair, keeping it small, and cross it over the right strand and under the left strand before dropping it down and clipping it aside. So essentially, you're placing the new strand in the middle of the two original sections of hair. And then when you cross the left strand over the right strand, you're kind of locking the new strand in place. So I'm just going to repeat these steps, continuing the waterfall twists until the braid reaches the back of my head. I brought in about 8 sections of hair, and it's important to make sure these are small sections just so you can create the braided effect when we create the other sections of the braid. And I also like to clip aside the waterfall strands as I go so they stay down in the braid and don't pop up at the top, which can create flyaways along the braid. I also don't want them to slip out at all, so the style stays in the pattern when it's finished. So once the braid reaches the back of my head, I'm just going to use a bobby pin to secure the braid in place so it doesn't fall loose. We can go back and fix this with each twist that we add in, so just make sure it's secured in place. And now I'm going to remove the clip and pick up a new section of hair next to the part right in front of the first braid that we just did. And I'm going to repeat the same steps as before, so I'm splitting the section into two pieces and crossing the left strand over the right strand. And when I pick up a new piece to bring into the twist, I want to only grab the waterfall pieces from the first braid. If there isn't one on this first crossover, which there isn't in my case, I'm going to pick up a section of hair that lines up with where a waterfall piece should be. And then I'm just going to cross it over the right strand and under the left strand. And then I'm going to drop it down and clip it in place. So now I'm going to continue the braid just like the first one. So I'm crossing the left strand over the right strand, picking up the next waterfall strand from the first braid. I'm going to bring it over the right strand and under the left strand, and then drop it down and clip it aside. And I'm just going to continue the braid, working my way around towards the back of my head, bringing in one waterfall strand at a time until they're all brought into the braid. So it's the same pattern as before. You're crossing the left strand over the right strand, bringing in a waterfall piece, crossing it over the right strand, under the left strand, dropping it down and then clipping it aside, and then repeating the process, locking it in place by crossing the left strand over the right strand again. And then once I've brought in all of the waterfall pieces from the first braid into the second braid, so they're basically crossing through the second braid, I'm just going to bobby pin the braid along with the first one so that it doesn't fall loose. And I'm going to repeat this same process twice more, creating a total of 4 waterfall twists. You can do as little or as many twists as you'd like. The more you do, the more it looks like some type of woven braid, and it can look really cool. I was going to do three, and then at the last minute, I decided to throw a fourth one in to give it more of a woven look, and I really love how it turned out. And as I do each braid, they're going to sit in front of the previous one. That way you can pull in the waterfall pieces from the previous braid. So it's important to start the first braid farther back on the head, and then that way you can move forward. Otherwise, you'll run out of real estate on your head and you won't have any hair. So just practice with it, and then you can kind of see where you need to start the first one, and then you can do the second one in front of that, the third one in front of that, and so on and so forth. Once I finished all four of the braids, I decided to add a really cool gold clip at the ends of my braids. I just wanted to add something a little bit more secure than just a couple bobby pins to hold the braids in place. And this clip did just that. It's made out of an alloy material, so it's very sturdy and firm, but it also added a really cool vibe, I think, to the hairstyle. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know in the comment section if you found this hairstyle easy to do or if you think it's more difficult, or you can click the thumbs up or the thumbs down if you enjoyed or didn't enjoy the video. If you're new to my channel, make sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you never miss a future video, and I will see you next time.